Hello. The HHS Office for Human Research Protections, or OHRP, created this video to help you learn more about a common type of research that uses existing information and biological samples that are left over from earlier medical visits. When you go to the doctor's office or hospital, doctors and nurses regularly collect information about your health and document it in your medical record. As part of your medical care, they sometimes run tests on your biological samples, such as blood, urine, or tissue from a biopsy. The leftover samples are generally discarded when they are no longer needed for your medical care, but medical centers also can share them with researchers for scientific research. Information from your medical record and leftover samples from your medical tests are valuable resources for science. Researchers can develop new treatments, learn how to prevent diseases, or gain important knowledge about the human body from this kind of scientific recycling that can benefit many people. For example, researchers might want to find out which of two common blood pressure medicines works better. They could conduct a big clinical trial to compare the drugs. In a clinical trial, people volunteer to take one of the medicines and agree to follow procedures for the research. Or maybe researchers could get an answer by studying information that already exists in the medical records of patients who are already taking these medicines. By reviewing patients' medical records, researchers can find out how well each medicine controls the patient's blood pressure and learn about their side effects. This way, researchers don't have to ask patients to do anything special for the research. By studying the data in medical records and leftover samples that were already collected for patients' clinical care, researchers do not need to have people go through additional procedures to collect their data and samples for research. In this way, researchers avoid exposing people to risks and discomforts of those research procedures. Moreover, using existing information and samples could save both time and money, and be a good way of using available resources to enable research on important questions to move forward. Often, when researchers use leftover samples or review health information from medical records, they don't know the names or identities of the people the materials came from. So, in this case, the information and samples are considered to be unidentifiable. Other common terms used to describe unidentifiable materials include de-identified and anonymized. Using unidentifiable information in samples helps to protect people's privacy because researchers don't know who the individual people are. In many cases, researchers don't need to know the identity of the people whose materials and data are being used in research. However, sometimes it is important for researchers to know the identities of these people. For example, researchers may need patients' names to match their tumor samples with their medical records to find out if their cancer responds to a certain treatment. In most cases, for research that is funded by the federal government, if researchers need to know who the samples or information came from, they must follow federal regulations that protect those individuals. The researchers must keep people's information confidential. Usually, they are required to ask people's permission before using their identifiable samples or information for research, except for some low-risk research when certain regulatory conditions are met and protections are in place. Research using leftover biological samples and people's health information has led to new knowledge and treatments for a wide range of diseases. For example, it has led to the discovery of cancer-causing genes, such as the HER2 gene found in some breast cancers, and treatments specific to these cancers. The ability to study health information and leftover biological samples is a key factor for the progress made in medical treatments over the last 30 years. Scientists regularly conduct these studies without knowing the identities of their sources. The practice is valuable and happens all the time. As researchers come up with new ways to study biological samples, and new technologies enable analysis of bigger and more complex data sets, the ability to use leftover biological samples and information from medical records to make advances in medicine and healthcare will expand, and the practice will become even more common. We hope that this video helped you learn more about research. We encourage you to check out the OHRP website at www.hhs.gov/about-research-participation to find other related resources.